that time, at a very young age, I already made that decision that there had to be more to caring for people than just doing tests and giving them drugs for whatever abnormal tests were found. The second thing that struck me was that most people, when they're sick, that the actual presenting illness has been preceded by years of stress, anxiety, depression, and other mental and emotional issues long before the actual physical illness appears. And many times when we do blood tests and x-rays and MRIs, these tests will only pick up disease when the disease is so far gone that it is impossible to reverse it. And one good example is cancer. And yet, if we are more observant of our how we feel in our minds, in our hearts, as well as in our bodies, we can be one step ahead of the game.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. That's quite interesting. Now, how does it work? Because in the recent past, have a couple of people. I know a couple of people that have died so young. Nowadays, people die at the age of 40, 36 of high blood pressure and all sorts of diseases. Now, you're talking about the build-up towards the let's say the symptoms of the disease. Are you trying to address the build-up, and how do you go about that?
Let me also add to what you just raised, the issue of high blood pressure. Among black people in general, and this is black people all over the world, hypertension is the number one disease. And then the number two disease is diabetes. The main problem is that black people in general historically have lived under extreme pressure, mental and emotional pressure, which has a lot to do with our cultural, shall we say, the fact that culturally we were taken out of the natural development and progression of our societies and suddenly immersed into an enforced Caucasian designed social structure. And because of that, there's been a lot of pain and suffering. And when I say pain and suffering, I'm not talking about physical pain and suffering as much as emotional and mental pain and suffering for many black people, especially among black males.
Okay.
And then to add to that, we're living in a society today that is so chaotic that most people do not have 1 minute of peace and quiet in their lives. There is so much noise pollution, air pollution, petroleum pollution, the water is polluted,
almost everything.
Everything is polluted. And then people are struggling for where their next meal is going to come from. So all these factors contribute to physical disease. However, when one stands back and looks at the extreme intricacy of the problem, where do we start? Do we just hand out hypertension pills to people? even when you hand out hypertension pills to them, they still end up dying of stroke.
True.
You know, so what? So from a holistic point of view, the answer is restoration of fundamental balance and harmony between mind, spirit, and body, and fundamental restoration of balance in the interactions or the metabolic interactions between all the organs. Because the hypertension, the result of long-term hypertension is chronic kidney disease. In Nigeria, I have to say that the Nigeria in particular has the highest incidence of kidney disease
in the world
among all black people.
That means across the world, or only
across the world.
Wow, that is, okay. That is serious.
And that's because kidney disease is the end product of chronic hypertension. But when a person has hypertension, the adrenal glands are suffering, the heart is suffering, the brain is not getting enough oxygen, the blood vessels are constricted, and because the blood vessels are constricted, all the other organs are not getting enough oxygen. So it is no wonder that people become ill at a very young age. And these are problems that were not endemic to our people.
True.
Until modern times. In the past, people, if a person did not die from infection in childhood, they tended to live to a very ripe old age.
Very true, 18, 19.
Right. But now, the highest incidence of disease is really chronic degenerative diseases, which are striking people in the prime of their lives. They usually starting around age 30.
Very true.
You know, and by the time they are 40, they're falling apart. So, what I'm here to do tomorrow is to talk to women in particular about true holistic health. And there's a difference between holistic health spelled with a W, which is W-H-O-L-I-S-T-I-C,
mm-hmm.
and holistic with an H.
Okay.
And people use those two terms interchangeably, but they're not really interchangeable. Holistic health with a W means looking at the whole person and bringing all the parts of a person together into balance and harmony in such a way that each part benefits from the activity of the other parts.
Okay.
And that means the spiritual part, and in Nigeria, people are very concerned about their spirits. Look at the number of churches.
Okay.
Right? Yeah. Everybody goes to church. And yet, there's a split. There's a split between their daily life and their
spiritual life.
Their spiritual life. There's no true connection. And we have to restore that connection where the spirit and the body are working together on a 24-hour, 7-day-a-week basis, not just spirit on Sunday, body the rest of the time.
During the week.
Yeah.
Now that's quite interesting about the issue of the spirit, the body, and the mind. And like you already pointed out, there are so many churches, so many religious houses, people go there every day. No, well, not every day, like a routine. Okay, Wednesday I have to go to church for midweek service. On Friday, maybe a night vigil or something. On Sunday, they pack the family and go to church. And on Monday morning, or let's say from Sunday evening, it happened to me before. Sunday evening, my mind goes a little bit crazy and everything that, oh my God, it's Monday, I have to go to work again. Then everything about me starts, you know, going a little bit crazy. And you are trying to bridge that gap so that people live their daily lives spiritually sound, mindfully sound, and also physically sound. Now, the question is this, why did you choose women, since men are mostly prone to these kinds of diseases and issues?
The reason I chose women is twofold. The first is that we are beginning to see that women are suffering from all the diseases that used to be relegated to men.
Right, true.
And that is because women are now an integral part of the social, financial, and economic fabric of the society. And women are taking on additional responsibilities that in the past they did not. In addition to that, women have historically been the backbone of the society. If you do not have a healthy wife and mother in the home to bring up healthy children and teach them how to be healthy, then you will not have healthy adults.
Mm-hmm.
And when you look around you today, the physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual health of our society is falling apart. Even with the enormous numbers of churches and the numbers of people that go to church every day, our society is still going down.
Mm.
And we need to ask ourselves, how can we change that? We're not going to be able to change that by talking to politicians or even in the schools. The way it changes is when each individual, one person at a time, looks around himself or herself and says, this is insane.
Mm.
I can't continue to live like this. I must bring about a change in myself, for myself, and in my own little surrounding.
You know, it's very interesting, because when I was going through the topics you're going to discuss tomorrow with these women, one particular topic caught my attention, that is the yoga. And I have on my program a teacher, a yoga teacher from Australia. She calls in every Friday and tries to demystify what Africans think of yoga. Now, are you a yoga teacher or a practitioner, or you just do the exercises, or can you relate yoga to the mind, spirit, and the breathing and everything in relation to what we're talking about now, the holistic idea?
Yes, gladly.